And there it is! It's up against Skrawl and Vault. That's so... a new thingy. But come on, we have two Deceive Realities, and a Study, and a Carve Reality. If this isn't the time for Master Reality, what is? On to the Watcher. Which will be another crack at the tiny house. Sweet. Will we get offered a pressure points this time? No, will we get offered a talk to the hand? Which seems like a pretty reasonable floor one card. Also got a cultist potion, which basically solves a Lagavulin fight. That does allow us, I think, reasonably to go for our Burning Elite in Act 1. Although there's a 3 Elite path I can take if I don't do that. Yeah, let's grab a talk to the hand. Act boss is Slime Boss. Noted. Okay, I'm gonna go for this 3 Elite path. And if leaning on the Cultist Potion, which is obscenely good for Watcher. Obscenely. This doesn't kill, unfortunately, but we only take 7. Interesting. Not actually a good set of potions to find this early. But, okay. Pekaw, I guess. Interesting set of 3 options here. What if I make myself take the early worship? Falling Bash could be a fun option too, actually. It combos quite nicely with the Talk to the Hand. And we're fighting Slime Boss. Yeah, I'm gonna take a Bowling Bash, actually. I think that's a very good starting card. And I feel spicy, so I'm gonna go with Transform a Defend. Into a Spirit Shield. That's a bigger, better defend. Gonna avoid the shop, even though we actually hit a reasonable total for a store. But we're going to probably go to this shop. Choo-choo. Maybe I was actually meant to talk to the hand in the front one there. Yes. It's okay. You know, actually, this works fine. Get a better potion? No! Consecrate, I particularly like with Talk to the Hand. Flurry of Blows is good too, of course, returning to our hand when we change stances. Or good old Empty Fist, get out of the current stance, also quite helpful. Again, because of Slime Boss, I'm gonna let myself be persuaded to lean in the direction of the Consecrate here. Also because of our strength gaining potions. But I think any of those 3 cards are completely valid in that position. Do I let the Talk to the Hand persuade me to take either a Just Lucky or a Sash Whip? Just Lucky is a fun little inclusion. Does a little bit of block, a little bit of damage, and lets you look at the top card. And that can be quite useful, especially in Slime Boss fight, to let us discard slimes. 3 elites between us and the shop. I think that's a price that's too high to pay, Mr. Serpent, but I do think we are well equipped now for the elite fights of Act 1, especially with these potions here. First up, the Gremlanius Nobulus will use our strength potion for the immediate damage output. I think we should only need the one, though. We don't need to use both potions. We'll want to enter Wrath with Eruption as soon as we draw it, which is right now. Let's just verify that that would be a kill next turn. With 2 points of strength, almost certainly. This will be 22 damage. Strikes will be 16, and this will be 18. So 56 damage. Yes, we can easily do that. Playing the defend actually makes us take one more damage, as it gives the knob 3 strength. But we're in Wrath, so it's 6 additional damage. So I'll pay my 12 HP to beat the knob, get a meal ticket healing us at the first shop, and one of these options. Deceive Reality is one of my favorite block cards on the Watcher, since it creates a retaining block for when you need it most. Or a wheel kick to draw 2, which is also quite nice given that we've added a couple of zero costers to the deck. I think I'm going to take the Deceive Reality. One, we just beat a Gremlin Knob, so there's less of a penalty for adding a skill. The other, I think it's quite useful against Slime Boss. And it helps us scale the Spirit Shield, too. Probably want to upgrade the Eruption first. I think the Consecrate gaining +3 is also really significant. Talk to the Hand is nice, but not so important for the next Elite fight, which is either Sentries or Legavulin. Good against Lega, of course. But against the Sentries, it won't matter much. In both cases, the Eruption upgrade is going to be quite useful. Get that Eruption upgrade first. I feel like we're going to be dependent on this Eruption for a while, for some reason. It is indeed Sentries first. Works for me. I don't feel the need to use the potion because we've added some cards that handle this combat pretty well, including the Bowling Bash. Ooh, I'm back to regret not playing that, Oh no, we have enough damage, good. It's not gonna be a useful Wrath. And by discarding one card off the top there, I'd go from a draw pile of 6 to 5, so that I get to reshuffle all of my cards back into the draw pile with these Dazed. Do something like this. Let's take one to get that Talk to the Hand played. That's an unfortunate draw order, but not too much of a problem. Only really 10 damage. Letter Opener will certainly be useful, dealing AoE damage if we play 3 skills on our turn. It makes an Evaluate a little bit more tempting, because it adds an insight to the draw pile, which makes the Letter Opener easy to do. Devotion giving us Mantra per turn is also pretty interesting. Slime Boss fight's pretty long. This card will definitely get used in that combat. Perseverance also helps scale the Spirit Shield, that's true, another retaining card, although I don't feel like I need another block card at this point. 22 health gonna be enough for either Lega or Knob. It should be, yeah, I should only need 16 hit points for Knob. Especially with this Cultist Potion. Although I might need more if I take a Devotion. I should actually skip here. Should go into our next fight. It's a very good find. With an upgrade on Consecrate. And we do get a Legavulin. Good. I think I should use the Cultist Potion for that. One safety full blocks, we get to keep the other one. Good. Should be a perfect fight. Is that lethal? This is 24. 34 times 2 is 68 plus 13, yes. Bonk. Score ourselves a white beast statue, giving us a potion now and forevermore. Ooh, Carve Reality is the attack complement to Deceive Reality. Gives us a retaining smite. I actually quite like this card. As an offensive one, especially in situations where you're a little bit behind on your damage. And that's definitely a case here. The Evaluate's better than ever now. We have both Letter Opener and Smooth Stone, too. And that's right, then we can take a Mass Reality and kind of pretend that it's actually doing something. More realistically, I can take a establishment and feel good about it. Can I buy a Frozen Eye and feel good about it? We actually have no card draw. The only thing is the Just Lucky. That doesn't seem that helpful. Yeah. But of course, as we get more card draw, Frozen Eye becomes more and more useful. Study with Letter Opener is pretty spicy, and that would be a real... Then we would have an actual reason to take Master Reality, hilariously. Ceramic Fish could give us gold for future cards. Nothing wrong with max HP. I actually think max HP is very, very valuable on Watchers specifically, when you're fighting the Heart. I agree that we currently beat Slime Boss, so we can kind of just build for Act 2 here. With Letter Opener and Smooth Stone, it's definitely Remove Strike over Remove Defend. Is Letter Opener Smooth Stone enough reason to take a second to Deceive Reality? I like this card enough that I would take 2 here. We could go Deceive and Study. That's not going to be a very good build, is it? That feels like it's a little slow, but kind of curious, actually. Alright, I'll try that. I don't necessarily think that this is the best line of play. Maybe a second Bowling Bash helps with that. Although the Letter Opener is going to do a lot of AoE damage now. Can't say that I do, Failure. Can't say that I do. No, this is actually kind of working out. Greater than or equal to 3. Yep. Hey, cut through fate to give us more scry. This is where the frozen eye would have immediately become really good. I'm gonna grab the tranquility is not the worst option here, I don't think. But I'm definitely gonna grab that, and I am going to anger the mushrooms despite my lack of specialization in mycology. Perhaps indeed because of it. Is what? Vigilance. Oh, actually, if we're in Wrath Stance, it'll be 18 damage? It's probably supposed to be Defend, Talk to the Hand, Bullying Bash. It's okay though. Take a little bit of damage, actually. I'll do what I originally planned. We should have killed the one with slightly higher HP. Ultimately, it doesn't matter too much. Odd Mushroom makes us take less extra damage when vulnerable. We are offered some zero-cost skills that scale really nicely with a letter opener, smooth stone. Or that wheel kick. I'll pass. And I'm going to upgrade the study so it's more easy to play. We're already, because we have a study, not really interested in a Snecko Eye very much. So I don't need to worry about that particular penalty of cost reductions. Right. We can then stockpile skills to use the letter opener with, or draw towards key cards on key turns. Should be very happy with Consecrate Spirit Shield next turn. Indeed I am. Ooh, or I can block with the Visual Arts. But no. Choose death. For my foes! GG! Oh man, an Ambrosia! And there it is! That's up against Scrawl and Vault. That's so... Which are definitely better cards. Actually, the vault is incredible here, notably enabling study to generate a new thingy. But come on, we have two deceive realities and a study and a carve reality. If this isn't the time for master reality, what is? So I'm going to allow myself to choose this master reality, even though I don't think it's actually that good. What it's going to do is cause the safeties to block for 4 more, it caused the smites to damage for 4 more, and most importantly, cause the insights to draw for 1 more. Literally placing me under arrest. Take this man away. Right now. Watch, and I'm gonna win from here because I have Ambrosias constantly coming into my hand, but we're gonna pretend it's because of the Master Reality. It's actually the potions, though. Oh man, Black Star. With an Ambrosia, I can definitely kill one elite. I think White Beast Statue makes Black Star pretty better in general. And this is definitely the kind of deck that will get a lot better with more relics. You could also take the Fusion Hammer. More energy is genuinely very good. More energy would mean the Letter Opener would do stuff way more often. We don't take Velvet Choker with insights and such. but I'm gonna try the Black Star. We're gonna try to get our energy the unconventional way. Cool, thank you so much for the 5 gifted subs. Welcome on into the Cozy Sub Club, everybody. And we're gonna fight ourselves at least one elite here. I'm thinking about this one first. We'll take probably a number of events along the way, because combats seem like they're gonna be hard. But maybe they won't be. What if everything was actually just really easy? What then? Able to just casually enter a Wrath there, in part because we have a stance potion to bail us out if need be. Definitely just draw lethal next turn, or lethal this turn. Don't forget, we are getting new potions, but we don't necessarily want to use the current great potions, unless they're saving us some hit points or something. I'll happily take a third eye for some scry. Second Bowling Bash is also maybe merited now that we're on Act 2 with a Black Star and 3 energy. Actually, that is a pretty good reason to take a second Bowling Bash. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. For Gremlin Leader and for, most importantly, 3 Slavers, we really want to be able to draw Bowling Bash turn 1, turn 2. Having 2 copies makes that a lot more likely to happen. Ooh, choose one of 20. Okay. Battle him! We can take the third eye that we just skipped. Or the Bowling Bash, if we want another one. Foreign Influence also pretty interesting with the Master Reality, as it generates card. Actually, it's also combos with a Letter Opener, and it's a card with an energy discount upgrade. Give me that. Alcapanek, thank you so much for the Prime sub in those 28 months. My how the time flies. Ritual Dagger. It's definitely one of the better Ritual Daggers I've been offered on Watcher. Ritual Dagger says, deal 15 damage if this card kills a non-minion enemy, permanently increase its damage. Getting stronger and stronger, really good with the various stance cards. Or we could take 50 gold for our next shop. Also quite valuable. Saves us a few hit points too. Haven't been liking the dagger as much. In situations where I feel like I can't get it upgraded or where I'm worried about my short term. Pass it again. Like a worse Oathbreaker, that's right. That's right. Alright, I'm doing it. We're playing the Master Reality. Contemplating Stance Potion here, but we won't. Bashar of the Ages, thank you so much for the 2 months and that Prime sub. Keeping it cozy. Let's see, how much damage is this? Currently we need to do 40 damage before Wrath. We want to kill. Currently have 24... 31. This has to be 9 damage for 1 energy. It was. Fear No Evil, a way to potentially leave Wrath's Dance. Increasingly valuable as the deck gets larger. Also potentially an energy generator for us. Good with Talk to the Hand. Yeah, I think we need this. Not my favorite way to do a Wrath entry, or a Calm entry rather, with this particular shenanigans, but that's all right. Cool rebound generation there. turn could hurt a bit. Not that bad. Okay. Let's see. This could be Master Reality, Deceive Reality, Safety Plus. This could be Talk to the Hand, Just Lucky, Deceive Reality, Safety. I should probably use the Dexterity Potion, since it'll save quite a bit of health this turn, and we're getting a new potion anyway. Yeah. That obviates the need to play the Master Reality, which I shouldn't want to play anyway. I probably shouldn't play the Study either, since each Study adds a days to the draw pile. Just play Vigilance Deceive Reality, but then I don't get to do any damage. I could go Vigilance, then Eruption, Deceive, Safety. We end the turn in Wrath, but we use the Safety? No. Let's take the slow route, I guess. Punished? Well, at least we're consistently able to block this. For how long? For forever, apparently. Easy. Just never take damage. Ever. Weird combat. Actually really like a skill potion. Skill potion will get upgraded by our Master Reality. Empty Body Plus, huh? It's another Wrath exit. Be a Calm exit. I'm worried we have maybe too many block cards, but I'm not going to turn down the free blues. Alright, on to our first Elite combat. I think I am going to upgrade the Foreign Influence, letting us play the generated attack for free. That can be an Immolate Plus or a Bludgeon Plus. Also like the Master Reality upgrade, making that zero cost. Okay. Instantly rewarded? Question mark? Yes, that's exactly enough damage, thanks to the upgrade, to kill both gremlins. Amazing. And I'm gonna go ahead and use the skill potion. This is also an upgraded skill. Bear in mind. Judgment plus in the deck for this fight? Actually unnecessary. I want Empty Mind or Wave of the Hand? With Empty Mind. Nice. need damage for next turn. Good. Let's see here. Eruption, Car, Bowling Bash takes out both minions. Shame I can't Bowling Bash the Gremlin Leader. Might do that. Can't play Study or Deceive Reality either. Okay, Fear No Evil's coming up next turn, so that'll protect me if we're being attacked. So we do have a guaranteed out. Let me get to some damage regardless. Okay, that looks like a good turn. Do Bowling Bash second. I get guaranteed Smite Plus on the leader. And if they're not attacking, this is just a good damage turn. Generate a block. Kind of an emergency option. Bonk. Very glad I picked up those double Bowling Bashes. What a great first elite fight with Blackstar, and what a great first reward, Potion Belt, giving us more potion slots with the White Beast statue. Incredible. Vajra for 1 point of strength. Excellent. And maybe one of these cards, mediocre. But I certainly feel capable of bopping whatever the next elite is. Go ahead and skip all this. Like, maybe Inner Peace? Nah, let's just skip it all. Got a full heal at the shop, and the membership card is back from him, the poor defect who died to Hexaghost. If we want more insights, the evaluate is here. Definitely gonna start by getting everything cheaper. What about Chrysalis? Wait, Chrysalis with letter opener? Master Reality? But I have to not remove a card to do that? It's gonna be so bad, right? I think. It's so good, though. Theoretically. Let's try it. I've never tried to do this. I don't think we want to upgrade it, though. But we do want it. And I... Dang, we've passed up all the opportunities to get Mantra so far. Never too late to start, and Chrysalis might be generating Mantra cards. I'm gonna take the Demaru. It gives us one Mantra per turn. I'm gonna try not to use a potion here. So far, not good. We're just gonna take some damage. Seems fine. We really need to do some damage. Crap. Although he can't attack me next turn, so this is fine. She might, though. No, she's buffing strength again. Plus 8? Terrifying. Okay. I think we've gotten control over this combat, but... it's oddly terrifying. We can draw these immediately? I'm in. What do you got? Wait, what? Card cost... Oh, and Baronium says, note on Chrysalis, card cost can be wonky if the upgrade is a cost upgrade. Note, in case such... this vault is, for some reason, actually two cost. But miracles anyway, so we're fine. a sweet interaction. That was cool. That was pretty cool. Alt. Heel kick minus, battle him minus. I'm gonna go with none of the above. We'll go into our second elite fight. The Book of Stabbing. This is definitely a fight that merits a power potion. I think we're a little bit slow when it comes to single target damage specifically. Likewater is some nice block immediately. Ooh, 24 on turn 1, that's extra bad. Establishment could be nice, too. Take the free steady. And deceive is on top. Okay, so we're not going to play the Vigilance, then. I'm just going to deceive. And since this is blocking perfectly, I'm going to play that too, Sense of Steel. This is definitely the fight I'm most afraid of. Get that Smite into my hand. My Empty Body Defend, is that a full block? It is, and it's a... new proc. I don't think I get a choice, though. Seems increasingly likely that I'm about to use my Ambrosia. I guess I should use the Master Reality and then the Foreign Influence. We can evaluate from there. Should create an upgraded card here. Pog. Alright, well that changes things. Does that mean we have lethal without the Ambrosia? If I go Fear No Evil first. Do some quick maths. 9 plus 10 is 19. And then double damage from there. So 86. 105 plus 20. 125 plus 26 is a kill. Yes, it is. Make sure we have enough energy for that. This puts us down to 1, back to 2. Yes, perfect. Bonk. What a beautiful outcome that was. Amazing. Terrainco, thank you so much for the 8 heckin' months. You played well, but after my streams, you're playing godly good. Very nice. Give me some Scry. This might be too many defense cards, but with an Art of War, I actually don't mind having a lot of block cards. And since we still have the Ambrosia, I'm going for the third elite, easy peasy-like. That Master Reality really came in clutch there, right? Ooh, strength on turn one, particularly good with the Bag of Marbles. We can take the Jacks to give us strength, or we can transform two cards. Turning... Be careful with the strikes, we kind of need them. I think one strike and one defend into two new cards. I like that. I don't think we have enough attacks, although the Bowling Bash would be excellent turn one with the Mutagenic Strength. So maybe we do want to consider Mutagenic Strength. Who knows what a Transform could be? What do we get? Deceive Reality number 3 and a Crescendo, Retaining Wrath. I actually love that. Love both of those. Very much. And I love cheap cards even more. I'm gonna upgrade this one. Ow. Yeah, this is the downside to removing your attack cards, of course. Yikes. That is 38 damage headed our way on turn 1, and I can do nothing about it. Ambrosia, unfortunately, doesn't even let me do anything, really. We can play the Chrysalis with the extra energy and the study. But that's all it is plus 3 energy here. We would do one letter opener, but we're still not killing any gremlins, even if I use the Ambrosia. Let's see what the top 5 are. What's next turn? Okay, Bowling Bash, yes. Talk to the Hand, yes. The thing is, we get more energy next turn. Yeah, I'm wondering if we use the Cultist. We'd also use that in the Bronze Automaton fight. Yeah, at least we didn't get a strength buff on turn one. Like a Crescendo. Okay, that's acceptable. That's spectacular. Free Predator Plus is also spectacular. Predator, actually. This could be 11 times... Six, 28. Question is, do I want to keep one of these safeties or not? I'm going to go with no. I want to full block this turn is what I want to do. Rigo Pillow incentivizes us to rest before Bronze Automaton, but I don't think I'm going to. Rush down here for some card draw on Wrath entry, which is somewhat useful. Might not take it, though. Warpaint did not, unfortunately, upgrade Chrysalis like I was kind of hoping it would. Deck doesn't want to rush down, you know? Although decks that don't draw Wrath very quickly don't want rush down, I guess is the answer. Feels like a long and slow kind of Bronze Automaton combat. I think we've got the block endurance to get there. Let's get this Talk to the Hand upgraded before I lose my opportunity to do it. Won't help much in this Bronze Automaton fight. But think we're mostly good for this combat. Definitely not going to eruption turn one when my exit's in hand. I'll have to draw the consecrate next turn, so let's just lose the talk to the hands. Get a smite into our hands. Obviously trying to preserve hit points early on here. Let's see what Chrysalis gives. A free omniscience. Nope, it's actually a three-cost omniscience. That's right. Although a real free spirit shield plus and a real free empty body plus, those will definitely help with blocking. Let's see. Incoming damage this turn, 24, block for 10, take 14. Oof. Save the skill potion for later? I guess so. You can just keep that, or whatever. Go for it. Free Meteor Strike. Yes. Commence bunk. Gauge additional bonkitude. Don't actually want to omniscience right now. That's the thing. Do I play a safety or no? I just kill you. Or just more omniscience. There. Of course, Hyper Beam is the big block turn, but we've got the big blocks with these safeties. Easy peasy. So I can Omni the Meteor Strike? Hell yeah! Let's go! Not even in Wrath who needs to be, GG! Reality. Deus Ex Machina is kind of nice for its miracle generating abilities. Sometimes those miracles will even be upgraded. Drinking fruit juice before you end of act heal actually doesn't increase the amount of hit points you'll get from the end of act heal, since the healing you get is based on your missing HP, and the fruit juice does not increase how many hit points you're missing. So we should see if we're getting a Sacred Bark, and I would very happily take a Sacred Bark and then get 10 max HP out of this. I think I'll take the Deus Ex. I think it's great with this letter opener. And with her Spirit Shield, too. Could take this Blasphemy for retaining Divinity. Oh, we do get a Sacred Bark! I'm in! Let's go. Sacred Bark says, double the effectiveness of potions. We're getting one potion every combat, and we are having four potion slots. So that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Enter Divinity. Twice! Hey, hey everyone. Did you know that you can now support me directly on YouTube by getting a channel membership? For as low as $5 a month, you'll get access to perks like custom badges and emojis to use in comments and discounts on the merch store, all while helping support me and this channel to do what I love every day. Just click the join button below to get started. Now back to the video. Might mean that I don't know, I have to go here. Okay. It's gonna be a tough fight. Take one event. Do I dare? Eruption Bowling Bash. 1, 2, 3 exits. Have to use the Ambrosia if I'm wrong. This way. Would have had to use the Ambrosia. Still have to use the skill potion, unfortunately. But Ascender's Bane and Chrysalis both really punishing me here. Two third eyes. But when you need more eyes, then you already have. Turn this miracle into a miracle plus, please. Thanks. It's definitely struggling on 3-base energy. Not surprising to me. But I'm curious to see how well we can make it work. So far, it's mostly with letter opener. Yes, we basically permanently have an orb slot now. Because of the foreign influence in the deck. It's a mod the spire thing. It's a little bit unusual. Do I want to meditate? It sure seems like a lot more next turn stuff. Maybe the tantrum's what we need, especially with the talk to the hand. For some immediate oomphage. But is it reliable enough? Find out. Spring voices. Don't want a riot curse. I will take one more event, actually. Yes, potions, thank you. An Entropic Brew is a huge find. I'll also take the Liquid Memories and the Swift Potion over these four miracles, which are cool but awkward. I need the card draw more than the energy, I think? Question mark? In the early parts of fights. Yeah, just like... Bees to card draw, thank you. I loose. Don't need a second tantrum. Oh boy, this is a tough customer. I think I'm just gonna go crescendo, play the attacks, and next turn we'll use Liquid Memories to try to kill it. Maybe I use Liquid Memories this turn because we have Vulnerable this turn. 54 damage to do that again. How much better than 54 can I do? Not much. Should have did it again. +24, which leaves it at 40. Should have done it again. But alright, that means we just have to use the Entropic Brew now, I guess. It's deeply unfortunate. Alright, we're one skill short. We get a 10 regen potion in replacement. I also quite like this Sanctity, blocks for a lot, and draws cards if the last card played was a skill. Yeah, the first elite is Max HP Reptomancer, which is definitely spooky. Is it spooky enough that I just want to kill her immediately? Let's see, if I drink the Flex Potion and the Ambrosia, Bowling Bash would be 13, 19... Well, it'd be 13 times 4.5. 58 times 3. It's only 174, actually. But I guess I can combine that with the third eye. Let's see what we're drawing next turn. Second Bowling Bash. So actually, no. Next turn we do the thing then, because it'll be a times 5 Bowling Bash. Okay. Cool. Oh yeah, it's actually 10 strength, you're right. Excuse me, it is 10 strength. Well, this works just as well, right? Certainly not a kill without. Nice timing with the toy ornithopter. Do get the scroll bar. Good stuff. Damaru Devotion, that's a real thing. Grab that. Error! Thank you so much for the tier 1 and the 7 months of support. Hope that sub was not made in error. Let's see, rest site or shop? Shop is a heal and we're rich. We'll go to the shop. Besides, the shop has cauldron, the shop has another fruit juice! The shop has boot thingy. I love it. Give me 10 max HP, please. For like 50 gold. That's a pretty good deal. Jack of all trades, shockingly good with Master Reality and Letter Opener. Definitely going to remove a card, though. Let's get rid of a strike. Then I removed every attack that I ever had. And wondered why I couldn't do damage anymore. Cultist Potion, 2 strength per turn, that's pretty sweet. Flurry of Blows looking better than before. It's a hilarious cauldron. I think I'll just take the boot thing. I am a boot now. Or at least a third. Ornamental Fan might have been nice, but Sapphire Key is demanded. A decent flex potion, too. Feels like we're okay without them. At least for now. I'm going to play the Talk to the Hand and not the Chrysalis. At least not yet. That all of this is going to help. Hey, look, it's helping. Keep drawing. Whoops. Not the insight. Devotion. Really good spirit shield, too. Maybe it was better to bank that one energy. Probably, in fact. Okay, Divinity next turn. That's the plan, then. Those aren't helpful. Those out of here. Okay, so currently Smite does 81 damage. That should be plenty then. Here's the Bag of Preparation, giving us 2 additional cards on turn 1. Maw Bank to give us money until we visit a store. That'll be a decent amount before the Act 4 shop, especially with the membership card. Fasting, no thank you. We don't have enough energy as it is. Feeling good here. We have some very, very strong potions gearing up into the late game. Do I want this third eye? Is the real question before me, I suppose. The answer to that is probably yes. We're gonna really need to lean on Art of War for energy. Schmuckster, thank you so much for that Prime sub. Welcome to the Cozy Council. Population... us. Good. can kill this lad with the letter opener if we need to. Help ourselves a little bit with the letter opener. Should have probably drank one of the potions there. What I should actually do is top up with a regen potion. We have a real tantrum now? Let's take a royal rush down. More card draw, please. Okay, we'll top up now, I guess. Good turn for Body Slam. Ganador, thank you so much for the Prime sub. Welcome, welcome to the Cozy Sub Club. Is in fact a chonky spiker. Meditate plus. With Rushdown Tantrum, this deck would love a Meditate. Putting two cards in the discard pile into our hand and retaining them kind of lets us seek out anything that we might need. Is Tantrum, Chrysalis, and Eruption all next turn? We might be being attacked for quite a lot of damage next turn, so I'm not really that comfortable with drawing most of those. Certainly not comfortable being in Wrath with 30 damage headed our way. This is a reasonable turn for the Speed Potion, unless we're hoping to maybe block the debuff of the Speed Potion somehow to beat the Heart. Would be definitely a way to do it. Try to save the Speed Potion Power Potion. As best I can. Orange pellets would get us there too. Yeah, they would. Part of the reason we picked up the Divinity Package is being still on 3 energy, it's very, very useful to get 3 immediately when we enter Divinity. Give me a wish! And there's the Ancient Potion to go with the Speed Potion, and potentially the Flex Potion. I was supposed to use the Explosive Potion before the combat was over, but that's okay. Maybe I'll keep it in case of Repto. Ditch the Power Potion now that we have Ancient Pot, Speed Pot for Heart. And it is Repto, so I'm very grateful for this Explosive Potion right now. But I might not need it on this turn. She's guaranteed to attack me this turn, because she can't summon when there's four daggers on the field. Is that wise? Seems reasonable. Now I get to do this. Right. None of this is block, problematically. Thanks for the setup turn, lady. What a double bowling bash. This will be 24 times 2 each. That should be a kill then. Good fire. Health galore. Pear puts us to 99 max HP, and the Pantograph will heal us for 10... Sorry, for 25. Start of each boss combat. Excellent, excellent. Another Consecrate Plus is not actually a bad damage option, although it does mess with our Art of War. Next up, Time Eater. Time Eater could be a bit of a problem for us. I guess we're looking to retain some attacks and to divinity turns. We've got a good block strategy. It's the studies that'll be a slight problem. Not a huge problem, but a slight problem. Is this worth playing? Body slam this turn? Hell yeah, it's worth playing. This would be so much damage. So far, extremely lucky attack pattern so far. No debuffs headed our way. At least not yet. No draw debuffs specifically. Next turn we get to talk to the hand. I have to get that devotion in play. Just the mean stuff, but it's not too mean. Hurts. With Pantograph, I don't feel like I need to prevent this damage with any of our potions, at least not yet. We're entering Divinity next turn, so playing Eruption is a-okay if I want to. can't play five cards, the problem. I think I'm gonna skip the study for now, then. It's a really unfortunate turn to be entering Divinity. Ooh, great turn to draw a Spirit Shield, though. Turn for Body Slam. We'll play the Chrysalis here. Getting a free Spirit Shield, that feels good. She didn't need to play the Miracle there. It's all good. Back those two. Not a bad Time Eater fight overall. We had worse ones. Enjoy the sleep, Lurk Ivy Blade. Have a good night. Oh god, what have I done? Okay. Well, by reading chat and talking about how good the fight was going, I made it go badly. Oops. Well, you should never talk, ever, while you're playing a video game. David, can you, like, die, though? Yes, good. Dear sir, thank you for dying. Okay, who's next? Book Bloke. Book Bloke does punish us for playing powers. So we gotta be careful not to play too many of them. Possibly not the study, but I am gonna play the Master Reality at the very minimum. Probably this Devotion, too. Three Sunder Plus, wow. What a generation for this turn. The luck. Still, it's 49. Okay, so that's gonna generate massive energy. in addition to killing the bird for us. And I can meditate it back. Do that again. Seems pretty good. Only boat thingy for block, but that's not the hugest of deals. So do I play the devotion? I'm gonna go with yes, I do. Turn 2 multi-attack is scary, but not that bad, actually. With Empty Body and Deceive Realities in hand, you can create quite a lot of block here. Yeah, we're actually just fine. Well, let's actually Miracle Cut Through Fate into that Vigilance. Play that instead. So keep the safety around. How about Rushdown? Do I play that? I don't think so. I think with the Divinity coming up, we use that for our offense instead. Curious what the Chrysalis gives this run. Or this combat. Alt. Prostrate Tranquility. You'd love to see it. Can hardly argue with more mantra, right? I think we want to use our exhausting cards in the first phase here. We can play the rest of our powers in the second phase. Opener. Okay, next turn is Divinity. Let's get that Sunder and the Carve Reality for maximum damage. And that might actually let me play this. Yes. And play Study and Rushdown. Wow, lucky draw there. Powers in play. Sneaky-like. Gotta play him when he won't notice ya. That's how it goes. Turn. Damage cards? Insight's like a damage card. Except not at all. Thank you. By the way, Mog, thank you so much for those 100 bits. Appreciate having you on the sidelines. Any relics that need to be set up here? You like it. Two thump, a deep pulsing dread can be felt throughout the room. Is this the heart of the spire, the source of master reality actually doing helpful things? Glance suspiciously at the heart, not sure if you trust it. But I tell you, if anything's gonna win this run from here, it's going to be the magical power of the sacred bark, giving us some awesomely incredible potions. Let's upgrade this tantrum for one additional hit that could be absolutely essential with the flex potion against Spire Spear and Shield. I think upgrading Rushdown to cost nothing would have also been a really good choice. We can bottled lightning here. Oh man, where we have a second ancient potion? Oh my goodness. What skill would I want on turn one? Third Eye Plus, probably. I think the only one we don't actually have is the Cauldron, and we did see that earlier, too. We almost bought it, in fact. But yeah, we got the full set of potion synergies here. It's quite effective. The thing I'm thinking about, that second Ancient Potion allows me to use Ancient Potion Flex Potion against Spire Spear and Spire Shield, and then Ancient Potion Speed Potion against the Heart, which I really like. I'll definitely be removing a card. Do we maybe just go, like, Orichalcum? It's not a great relic, but it does chip in sometimes. And if I was going to remove any one card, it would be... Eruption? Bend? Strike Plus is actually quite helpful. Goyal feeling the battle hymn. I'm a little worried about my ability to actually play the Smites. Oh no, 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 we'll have Divinity. Yeah, I am also feeling this battle hymn. Gamblers could definitely get me out of a tight spot, Gunch style. And then the idea would maybe be Flex Potion and one Gambler's Brew and try to kill Spire Spear, Spire Shield that way. With just one really quick burst of power. Don't actually need to block Vulnerable against Heart that much because of the odd mushroom, notably. Although we will if we carry an Ancient Potion to Heart. Or no. Heart is, I believe, vulnerable, weak, frail? I want to say frail is last. Yeah, okay. I think I'm sold. We only really need the strength potion on one turn. And I do like the battle hymn. In which case, I might as well take the Orichalcum, and I also might as well buy the hand drill. Let's go. Whenever you break an enemy's block, apply two vulnerable. It's only the time snail. The heart applies. Heart always applies frail. Actually, I immediately wish I could keep this 10 strength. Dang it. Shield next turn is okay. Battle him, you're a little late. Gee, how much damage is this? 24 at the time. 4 plus 14 plus I can play all of these. 9 plus 7 plus 13. 67. Plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 plus 70? It's 137. Okay. Wait, this only hits two times. Shoot. Still correct, I think. So close to a kill. Play this then. Dang it. It's fine, I can't push through. Looking good. Oh, I should not have done that though. Let's see here. No, I should not have done that. I don't have an exit. And I don't think I have a kill either. No, I definitely don't. So I guess we need to use the third eye to shuffle the draw pile and probably also the deceive reality here. Next turn, we're taking the times to attack. I'm really afraid about that. Don't tell me I did a dumb. Hey, good. Easy game. You still take a lot of damage on this turn, unfortunately. That's what the pantograph is for. Very much what the pantograph is for. Calipers might be good here, letting us retain block from turn to turn with, don't forget, 10 bonus dexterity. And either a prostrate, which I think is going to be the take, or a top to the hand. Keep this prostrate because of the bonus dex. What a great set of relics to have found. So Ancient Potion plus Speed Potion, that's 11 Dexterity for this turn. Put Tantrum back in the draw pile, sure. Don't get any Vuln. We get Devotion down turn two. I have way too many Deceive Realities in my hand. Who thought this would be legal? This is not legal. Reject your reality and substitute my own. I guess I should just play these now while I can. Calipers are good here. Play the exhausting stuff. We got. Oh, those aren't upgraded! We got Alpha Beta Omega, though! Didn't get Tuck of the Hand down before Artifact came into play, unfortunately. Into the draw pile. Meanwhile, 6 times 15 is happening. Can I maybe draw into Divinity so I can actually play the Omega? That'd be nice. This helps. So Omega plus to 100, it only does 60, but 60 is a lot. Failed to get it in play, too. About damage on these divinity turns. Okay, divinity next turn. Makes this a reasonable wrath turn. Get a little bit of damage in here. Yeah, that's good. And the ideal hope is that we can somehow kill next turn. Otherwise, we're staring down an awful lot of damage. By 15 with only 3 energy to spend this turn. The good news is we have 89 hit points, and I might need them all. How's it going there, Lupin? Hey, hey. Eight by 15 sure is a big number. Dang it, Omega. Get out of here. Enough that I can't block with my own two-face. Well, this is gonna be ugly, because there's gonna be a lot of wounds added to the hand here. To the deck. Yeah, just add, you know, 8 or 9 of those. Easy peasy. But then we're there. GG. The Tiny House Watcher makes it work.
Hey, hey everyone. Thanks so much for watching. Did you know that I'm live 5 days a week on Twitch? Come join us to watch me live, ask questions, or chill with the community. Click the link in the description below to follow and be notified when I'm live. And while you're down there, make like a sandwich and sub to this channel for more fresh Baylor content. Ta-ta for now.